was my year after school where I'm off, and I didn't want to just go on a normal vacation.
It's been the best thing I've ever done.
I think people grow a lot,
You learn a lot more about the actual culture, I think.
To be thrown in at the deep end and not knowing what to do, I think you just learn to cope.
They really need our help and you really connect with the children.
It's just doing something for not only for your own sake, but also knowing that it matters for some other people.
The next 2 weeks that I'm going to be here is going to be a life-changing experience.
For someone to decide to volunteer his or her time to help a certain society is a good heart, and they are doing a good job.
They have been teaching, assisted by the teacher we have here. We give them the plan that today we are teaching this one.
They normally teach English. English is a very important language, because once you go anywhere, it's the language that you can use it easily to communicate with people.
I could volunteer.
Proactive people, hardworking people that come and are committed to the projects. People that have got a lot of, I don't know, energy about them, spark about them.
You have to be open to very different living conditions.
When things go wrong, they don't take it personally, because it isn't personal.
Anyone can be a volunteer. Absolutely anyone. It's just, it's something you can slip very easily into, unless you're a really horrible person.
You don't really need any skills at all, just willingness and the ability to try new things and an open mind for the experience, pretty much.
Those who don't have special skills, they need to be devoted, just to be ready to help.
There is a language barrier, there is a cultural barrier. So we decided that we need to take some old volunteers who have been volunteering and coming back as a team leaders.
It has been really good. We have the best team leader. He will just do anything for us.
He's there all the time. You can ask every question and he will answer you and all find it out.
It's amazing how they can help you, and they always try to find the best way out of problems.
I have had some problems. I have been to the hospital and he went with me and helped me. When I was afraid and didn't understand anything the doctor told me, he was just calm down. Yeah, really nice, but also with the paperwork and visas and everything.
They just help you out with everything. And whatever you need, they do it. Whatever you want, they get it, which is great. I mean, you obviously don't ask much.
You need a lot of help because I didn't really know what to expect when I came down here.
I didn't know that you can just tell them, okay, I would like to go to Mashi this weekend and I would like to see this waterfall. And they just find out how can you do and order the bus tickets and all that stuff. I thought I would do it myself. But actually it's quite nice that they help us so much. Then you can keep focus on your job.
In the morning, the children come at 8, they have mathematics subject, English subject, they have break for 45 minutes, and they have some porridge, yes, but there are some, they are coming from poor families, so they just get one meal. So some stay here until they eat lunch, then they go back home. Some they have families, while some they stay with their grandparents because their father and mothers already died. Some from HIV, some from other diseases, but they are happy. They are happy, and you know what? We love to have them and to help them. We thank God to get the volunteer because they teach our children now. They know English. They teach the children. They play with them. They are the one who paint this class. They are the one who make this desk. They are the one who teach and bring the school equipment for the children and also to teach them. So they've done a lot of things volunteer. That's why we love them.
What you see in the TV and newspapers does not really, you can't explain how the people are.
They're very friendly. They're always saying hi and mamu and habari.
They're very warm, welcoming people.
They really like the volunteers. They know we do some work down here and to make it better for them.
They are always smiling and they try to get the best out of what they have.
They are always positive.
there's no bad words. If you say Mambo, they always say Poa, good.
They really want to tell you about their country and they want to show it.
In their spare time, they just, enjoy each other and, come together. And I like that.
I have made a lot of friends out here, definitely.
Yeah, really good friends, and we will definitely stay connected when we come back.
I have met a lot of friends here. It is so good.
It's nice to know that you can't get on with anyone from anywhere. I've never really travelled or gone outside my group of friends. So it's nice to know that you can do it.
And in our spare time we do a lot of things. We go out in the evening and we play cards and we sell money and we do sports together.
You know, when you're together every day for so long, you just get really, really close to people.
Everybody's like open and everybody wants to make friends, and you've got these ideas when you come down here about your plan for a trip, and then you meet a lot of new people and you just make new plans.
You meet some amazing people. I've met some incredible people since I've been here.
In the other side of the world, but still you have the same visions, and ideas of how you should help other people if you can.
Often when I see children, they stay without parents, and they stay without no caregiver, and they go to collect food in the dump. When I see it is painful in my heart.
Where is the money?
I feel better when to play or when you stay with your fans, and to see your fans, they are sleeping well, they are eating well.
I am lost, you pussy, pussycat, you pussy, pussycat.
Girls that went up Kili all completed and come back.
We took all the kids to the beach and they were so happy, they just ran around in the sand.
I climbed Kilimanjaro with the two of the others.
The Maasai village, it was so different from anything I've ever experienced.
All 50 kids just did like this
quick fire times tables and we all got it pretty much straight away.
I turn around and there's 10 of the kids from the orphanage.
We looked at each other, okay, don't look at me because then I'm going to cry.
They know their stuff, they've taught them out.
And I was just, I was so close to tears. I did cry a bit.
I've been taught to push to my limits on projects here, but it's been a good thing.
Yeah, I didn't think there'd be that many mosquitoes, but there actually are. I thought it was all a myth. But it's true.
I survived the Dala Dala. It's because the Dala Dala, the small buses here, are crazy to travel in, but they are so funny. Sometimes you feel like you're falling out of the bus, but I haven't fallen out yet.